Hey everybody, it's Victa Huntington Street here, the Binding of Isaac Victa Afterbirth Plus series. Thank you everybody for the support. Yesterday's video did cross 6,000 likes, getting us another double tally as the streak continues, the streak within the streak. Thank you all very much for all of that. And also, everyone sending the kind words to my dad. That was something that brought a real genuine smile to his face. Thank you all very much. He was reading them and he was happy. I was happy too. Here's your meme of the day. This one brought to you by first time submitter World Ka. Title was Good Morning Pin. Ah, yes. Good morning, sunshine. Slash R. I mean, look, I've talked about people getting kind of bored of the meme of the pin with the steel chair meme, but I think it's still pretty good. I think there's still some that can be milked out of there. Thank you very much, World Ka. Oh boy. CJ is gonna be 4 Whiskey Lima 1 Delta Mike Tango Delta. We have ourselves another Crooked Penny start here, which I feel like we just got done doing not that long ago. 4.19 days. I mean, like, it was like 2 days ago, wasn't it? We're also starting with the virus, of course, which is the reason why our movement speed is so bad. But also, the virus is a very, very good item for us to deal damage, deal with contact damage, and also a very good way to farm up some soul hearts if we're lucky. However, starting with 2 soul hearts as our only primary source of HP is a little bit dangerous. And yeah. It's been a little bit since we've had a Mom's Knife run. I will testament to that. Someone have to look up and see when was the last time Mom's Knife was actually taken. So obviously with Mom's Knife, this gives us a huge advantage. However, what I will say is that it's not, don't write this one off as a one run yet. The reason why I say that is because of our movement speed. Our movement speed is our greatest limiting factor and our greatest danger. In this run, we could very easily get thrown for a loop here and possibly, you know, we get caught by a champion shot and then unable to get away from another champion shot. And I mean, that's just it. The streak's gone after that. So, have I lost Mom's Knife runs before? Yeah, I've lost a couple. I wouldn't say that I've lost many, but I have definitely lost a couple. Gonna break my own rule here and use our only bomb, but, the only reason why I did that is because if we need another bomb, we can go over here and buy one. Plus, we had a penny-eyed keeper in there, so that means that there's a very good chance that we're going to get a nickel off of that one bomb, and I think that was definitely worth it. Especially in hindsight, now that we know that it paid out. So, Mom's Knife, of course, one of the best items in the entire game, one of my favorite items to play with. It gives you a massive amount of damage. Some people like it, some people hate it. I personally don't hate it. I've never hated it. I think it's a fantastic item. Its biggest downfall, of course, and this is just the elephant in the room that everyone loves to harp on, is just that it gives us the samey type of runs and stuff. Like, you know, there's not a whole lot of interesting synergies that you can do. I don't know why I decided to use the Crooked Penny there. I meant to use the Death Card and end up going with the Crooked Penny. Gonna take Mr. Dolly, just the range here and the HP, and we'll head on down. But we've got ourselves a pretty solid start, I'd say. Last day of February. October is right around the corner. Hey, look at that. Yeah, we're starting to get cooler weather outside. Got another blank rune here. I'm gonna use this blank rune, but I'm gonna wait in case of it procs a Yara rune. I want to get some stuff on the floor that would be useful to Yara, or if we can use it in the item room. That way, like, if it's a Perthrow rune, we can just simply roll. Justice, excellent pickup there. Of course, we know that where the secret room is, which is right there, thanks to the Ansa's rune. Probably should have left that full charge there. There's no reason for me to take that, but I did it anyway. And I'll do it again. I'll do it again. As you see right here, this is another problem. Common problem with piercing shot tier effects like Mom's Knife or anything else that is piercing shots. We're unable to save ourselves from any troll bombs that get thrown at us. So that is something to be careful. And again, with this lack of movement speed, that makes it dangerous, man. It really does. We got to be careful here. I don't want to seem like I'm sandbagging or you know, anything, but it's a concern. The lack of movement speed is very, very scary. But of course, the flip side is that we have massive amounts of damage thanks to Mom's Knife. And like I said, it's one of the more talked about items, mainly just because from a viewer standpoint, people are sad about it because it's like, oh, it's a one run, or oh, you know, there's no real diversity when it comes to Mob Knife's runs. And I kind of disagree with that. You can get a very interesting Mob's Knife run if you have, like, say, I don't know, multiple shots like 20-20 or inner eye or quad shot, something like that. Skipping Stone is quite a hilarious one. You know, Ludovico is also a fantastic one to get. So, I mean, I wouldn't necessarily say that there's no good item synergies. Maybe there's no interesting ones, maybe, if that's the main reason behind it. We get a Degas rune in there, which is just going to give us a Soul Heart. But, I mean, I've never had a problem with Mob's Knife. I understand the criticism, though. This is a conversation that we have every single time. And my long time subs are like, oh, God, here we go. No, that's basically all I've got to say about Mob's Knife, is just that it's a good item. I don't shy away from it. And especially if you're a newer player, I would highly, highly, highly recommend taking it. It gives you a new way to play, and also is just one of the best items in the game, period. I mean, you want Mom's Knife. It gets you wins. Finish my bottle of water there. And even with all this extra HP we've got, it's not enough for me to feel comfortable because of... If we can get flying, then I'll feel much better if we can get flying. We have to get something that helps out our mobility. That's the big talking point right now. Mobility is definitely down to the dumps. The golden question mark that we got in the store will give us a guaranteed double item room inside of our item rooms. And you know you're slow when you can't even make it across across two of the Isaac Head statues without getting possibly nailed there by one of the shots. Super Seeker rooms right there, pretty much almost guaranteed, I would say. More people on the Civicta subreddit have been sharing the fact that the pin meme, the pin mod, the steel chair pin mod, has been ranked number one on trending for Isaac, and that's just awesome. It's so cool, man. It really is cool. Whether you're sick of the meme or not, it's truly a golden age of the mosh pit right now, and I'm loving every second of it. And I promise you, I make this promise to you all here, is that I will show off that mod one way or another. Get more shot speed and range, which is not what I want. However, we get Lord of the Pit, and also we get Empty Vesselu. Which I'm going to take both of these, and here's why. Remember, if we have an empty vessel, we have flying as long as we don't have any red hearts. But the problem is that if we get red hearts, we lose that flying capability. And also because Lord of the Pit obviously is a movement speed upgrade, which again is something that we've been needing for this entire run. Figured I'd try it. No harm in trying. I don't recommend using the Crooked Penny on stuff that you like need. You know, like, if you cannot afford to not have Black Candle, then do not gamble it on it. Expect to lose. Let's put it that way. All right, so there you see the Empty Vessel shield coming up here, and that's going to give me a perfect opportunity to poison these targets with the virus. I'm not going to use our keys yet because we might be able to bomb our way in there. Doesn't look like we can. The Empty Vessel shield will only activate as long as we have no red heart showing, and... And it will activate either on the 20-second, the 40-second, or the null or 0-second of every minute. It's one of those three. I think there's a set time in between when the proc actually happens, but I'd be lying if I said that I remembered what it was. That's a super secret room right where I said it would be. You know, the Soul Heart, we're starting to feel pretty good about this run now. Still want some more movement speed just because 1.06 is pretty bad, but it's not 0.76 bad. And we'll head on down. We're just cruising through this one. We could, if I really wanted to play that golden chest, we could. I mean, there's no real reason not to, other than the fact that we just have two keys, but I'm willing to take a gamble. Two bombs for one key is fine, I think. So you see right there, Mom's Knife does deal contact damage, although I don't know how much, not exactly sure how Peep managed to avoid all that contact damage there, despite us not moving. That was weird. It was like we clipped into him or something. So we got the full charge on the Cricket Penny. Got greedy there. Should have just let it rip. Definitely deserved to be hit for that one. Wow, I'm actually stunned that that first bomb fly actually took that. That's incredible. It took a full second of uptime, of damage uptime from the knife at 4.18 damage, which isn't a lot, but still, like, that's quite impressive that that bomb fly lasted that long. I thought for sure we were going to get ourselves a free mushroom bombing there. Okay. Yeah, there we go. That's what I thought was going to happen, but it just didn't the last time. That was nuts, man. That was crazy. How bomb flies be crazy. Knee-jerk reaction is to buy the soul heart. I'm not going to. I wish I had. Remember, we have goat head as well. If I didn't explain what that item was already, it gives us guaranteed goat. It gives us guaranteed goat head, but also guarantees a devil deal on every floor, which is very nice. And considering that we do have the deal with the devil precedent, thanks to us getting empty vessel to, and the Lord of the Pit, that means that we have devil deals from here on out. And seeing a floor two goat head is pretty darn nice, I gotta say. It just makes your runs a lot easier. So far, so good on the subject of actually like taking the knife versus not. Now, if we had had an interesting tier effect, like, I mean, anything, like if we had had like Jacob's Ladder or Death's Touch or something like that, then like I wouldn't have taken Mom's Knife. But at the very start of a run, especially when you're starting with only 2 HP, it's kind of difficult. You're going to be hard pressed to convince me not to take that. So we get Book of Revelations, which is going to guarantee us at least one orbital here, which is good. And also gives us a soul heart at the on use for every full charge. Here's our last bomb here for this nickel, maybe. Yeah. Okay. Let's go back and get that full charge on the opposite end of the secret room so we can get ourselves another soul heart. And we are going to be feeling good. Looking good, feeling good in the neighborhood. What is that? Is that Allstate? No, that's your good hands. Who's feeling good in the neighborhood? I don't remember what business has that quotation. So again, we're just backing that thing up into the enemies here because we want to try to poison touch them. And as soon as they become poisoned, if they die while they're poisoned, they have a very high chance of paying out with a black soul heart, as you just saw right there. And let's go ahead and use this bomba on this bomba chesta. And okay. So the blister is actually not terrible with Mom's Knife because we do get a pushback, which again can be very, very useful and actually life-saving. Super secret rooms right there, and it was a whole pile of nothing. This is like the longest map I think I've seen in a very long time. No pun intended there. So here's our orbital. Good damage there with Mom's Knife. Wallow's victory. We get ourselves a ball of bandages, which is very nice. We get the pact, which has been showing up quite a lot lately, and I am A-okay with that. But seriously, it was great to see Dad, you know, so moved by everyone's kindness, and it was cool. It was very cool, and you know, he doesn't usually. You'd have to know him. But you know that, and that's the thing I always stress with people, especially people who don't know like anything about my content, or they just don't know anything about YouTube. It's like, you know, I always revel in the idea. For some reason I thought I wasn't going to take contact damage with the hat close. I don't know why. I always revel in the idea of reminding myself constantly that the people who watch these videos are real people. You're not. I think that a lot of content creators out there, man, no, I hate that term. I think that a lot of YouTubers and streamers, I feel like they tend to just pass their fans or their viewers off as just some nameless, faceless gobs on the internet, you know, that don't really matter. And I'm constantly reminded of how awesome it is to actually talk to the people who watch these videos like they're people, like they're genuine people, because you guys and gals are, obviously. And when that gets put into perspective, it's kind of like, man, this is really, it really is amazing. It is truly remarkable what we've got here. You know, I think that there's a lot of people who probably don't even, I guess, think like that, which is true. I might just have a weird brain. I don't know, but the little things like people like listening to the words that I say and responding appropriately in the comment section, you know, like it's obvious that people are like listening and stuff. You know, that like that's to me that's more mind blowing than anything that I'll ever accomplish on this planet. It is just knowing that people are listening to you. And they want to support you and take care of you is really cool, and you can't get that really with any other profession. I don't think that I at least none that I can think of off the top of my head anyway. Very happy we got the Halo, by the way, all stats up, giving us more movement speed, thankfully. And I will take jumper cables. I think we can just put the rest in. Welcome back, donation guy or girl. I saw you in the comment section yesterday. Good to see you again. Long time no see. I'm pretty sure. It's even better. Safety scissors means that we don't have to worry about running away from troll bombs anymore. We just get the bombs. Kind of like this. Yeah, you can have that penny. Black War. Obviously, I'm not going to take this because I don't want a level two meat. Level two keep meat, or level two ball of bandages. Does not use the shadow, obviously. So I'm gonna take betrayal here, only just because why not. Well, head on down. But it's not all... That was horrible. That was absolutely horrible. It's not all sunshines and lollipops, though. I mean, like, there are people who genuinely don't like our channel. There's people who don't like me personally, for one reason or another, and I think that I've gotten a lot better about not. I've never been one to focus on those type of people, outside of like just saying like, hey, this person said something stupid. I'm gonna crucify this comment, you know, and post it up. And it was the other real people at the mosh pit who brought up a good point. It's like, well, that's still kind of focusing on the net, like, you know, why not pin up something positive instead of something negative, that sort of thing. And it was after someone had told me that I really took a good long look at how to approach people who don't like you. You know, I know tons of creators who've driven themselves mad over that kind of thing, over worrying about, you know, well, you've got 100 people who say they all love you and they support you and they care about you, but it's one person sticking out of that 101 person crowd that like can ruin your day. And I've never been the type to be like, yeah, my day's ruined because of this one jerk. You know, I always revel in taking the fight to somebody like that. You know, if they say something silly or something dumb or, you know, or whatever, just being rude, I like to call them out on that, because it's like, yeah, you know, I think you should, you know, if you feel that way, you should own up to your words. I think that I think that people are more apt to change their ways if you make them realize, like, hey, by the way, I saw what you wrote. And I think that's a mature way to deal with it. That, and sometimes it's just funny. Sometimes people say something so outlandish and asinine that you, like, I just got to make fun of it, you know? And that's the other side of the coin that is working on the internet. Dude, if that would have hit me, I would have been so mad. We've got extra bombs here. We might as well roll for something good, hopefully. Compost is there. Hive mind is good. Get Diplopia. Now, amazingly, we still have not found our item room yet. But Diplopia may be an option for us. If we like both items inside of our item room, which is possible. We have a Stars card, which is going to get us out of Boss Rush. So we might as well go to Boss Rush first, because that saves us the key from going into the item room. Oh, my bad on that one, Isaac. Speaking of re-rolling, I started playing Genshin Impact, which is, I believe it's related to Honkai Impact or something like that. Some game like it was named like that. I never played that one, but I tried Genshin for the first time last night. Like I said, I was going to on yesterday's run. And it's actually very, very good. It's being written off kind of unfairly, I think. And let me take that back. I don't have a dog in this fight. I don't care. We got time to go to the devil deal. This is going to give us Bookworm, I think. No, we didn't take the Bible. That's right. We rolled it with a Crooked Penny. That's right. I don't have a dog in the fight, but people have been calling Genshin the... this isn't even worth it, but I'll take the body. The star. Yeah, this also isn't worth it. Give me Papula Duplex. People have been calling it an anime Breath of the Wild, and I never played Breath of the Wild, so I can't attest to such a comparison. But what I will say is that the combat's super enjoyable. There are gacha elements in there, but the game gives you some pretty good characters at the start, and you don't have to pay for it. And I've been kind of waiting for a game like this to come out that has gacha. It does have gacha. It is a character gacha and a weapon gacha, which is really going to turn off some people. I will admit that I'm not a huge fan of weapon gachas. I think that it should either be characters or it should be weapons. It shouldn't be both. Because that's just... As someone who's played gacha games for a long, long time now, and I would consider myself a veteran of the genre, it's an easy way for the companies to just pad their RNG in their favor. Because they could say, yeah, you know, you can get this cool limited character, you know, but also you have to dodge all the weapons that are on the gacha. You know what I mean? Like, they don't just have a limited banner for one character. You know, you have to dodge all of the weapons and the accessories and stuff. So I'm not a huge fan of that. That's kind of the reason why I didn't like Fate Grand Order. And I will say that Genshin Impact definitely took a couple pages from FGO, for those of you who played it. So that may turn some people off. But what I will say is that for a free game, the game is unbelievably gorgeous. Is so well done. The graphics are amazing. The combat is wonderful to play, very, very smooth and solid. It's hard to believe that the game is free. I have not spent any money yet, but I probably will, just because I've been having fun with the game. But I don't know if I'm going to stick with it or not. I've been kind of waiting for a game like... Is it done? Yeah, it's done. I've been kind of waiting for a game like this to come out, like a gacha game where we're not just lining up a bunch of like... template character, like auto farming, auto battling characters. Like, you actually get to play as the characters that you've drawn. Like, a Nat 4 is wildly different from the next Nat 4, or a Nat 5 feels overpowered. Something like that is I've been waiting for a very long time now. And so it's very cool to see it done in a particularly well way. I will say that Dungeon Hunter Champions DHC, some of you, if you remember that game, some of you might. They tried to do something similar where you had like this kind of, you had this sort of like third person ARPG feel to the game. But you never really felt like you were playing as them. But with Genshin, you've got this over the shoulder third person point of view, much like a Breath of the Wild or, you know, or name any third person action adventure game. That makes you feel like you're getting more response from the character on the screen rather than just being a top down. So it's a neat game. It, like I said, it's free. This is not. I wish it was paid promotion. If Genshin Impact, for some reason, if you're listening to this Isaac episode, you want to throw some bucks my way to do a sponsor, no, hey, I'll do it. This is free publicity right now. But yeah, I would say check it out. It's free. You can get it for PlayStation, Windows, or the mobile devices. I don't think it's out on Switch. I could be wrong on that. I believe it's cross-platform, but it does have multiplayer as well. So, we go down here. We go down here. That's right. Now I'm just making sure that I force myself to remember that, hey, we've been down there. So Genshin Impact, not too shabby. I'm not sure if I'll whale out on it or not, but I think that I'm gonna try for one of the good characters. It's just for me, I really dislike weapon gachas, man. That's really the only downside to that. But as far as like aggressively like marketed and stuff, or you know, are there a bunch of pop-ups that tell you to play the gacha, blah blah blah. There's none of that. It's very hands off. It's not invasive. After you're done with like the tutorial and that sort of thing. By the way, full clear. La 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 la. It's a funny game. You know what? Let's do it. We're not going to Delirium. If anything, we start with Cursed Eye. That's great. If anything, this could be a good showing as to why I don't like Missing Now. So, fans of Mom's Knife, I'm sorry, but I think that it was obvious that we're gonna win this one now. Oh, we have Taurus as well. I think we have Taurus, but our movement speed's not going up. It's kind of weird. Maybe it's not active until we get to the next floor. Which is ironic because we have Missing No, so we're not going to be able to hold anything. So what Missing No is, by the way, is it will completely reroll your character every single time you go down to a different floor without you have no control over it. And there's no way to get rid of it other than, I believe, the Stick of Butter trinket. You have a chance of it actually becoming dislodged from Isaac, but the chances are very, very low, especially if you've taken a lot of items before. Missing No, as you saw, oh, hey, our movement speed is going up. Missing No did not re-roll the Book of Revelations, which is nice. So, but the reason why I don't like Missing No revolves around the fact that you just can't feel good about your run because you can't get attached to your run because it just changes on you, even when you don't want it to, and that's not fun. So we don't get to deal with the devil despite us having... We did have Goat Head on this floor, I think. Got the Mom transformation. We got restock modem lag. I don't know about this one, Mr. Krabs. Well, luckily, SpongeBob, the boss is right around the corner here. But as you see, we've reverted back to our base damage and base tears rate, which I'm not overly enthused about. Also, apparently we don't have flying. I don't know why I thought we did. It's interesting that we've completely reverted to our beginning stats. Bro. The modem lag. Okay. Let's go back and get those full charges just to get our HP back. Yeah, so that lag that you're seeing right there is a result of modem lag, and modem lag is terrible. It's one of the worst items ever. I don't know why it exists. So if you see the stuttering or the disappearing shots like that, you know that it's not my computer this time. It's actually modem lag. So we just lost 6 HP there, just casually. Modem lag does not, it doesn't only affect shots, it also affects some enemy movements and stuff. So, yeah. Bad gas, feels like walking in sunshine, telepills, range up, I'm drowsy. Probably gonna go for the I'm drowsy against Isaac. And we'll use the stars card in the chest. I'm drowsy is gonna give us a stopwatch effect for the room. I am a little tempted to play that, but I'm not going to. And luckily, we still maintain our 9 lives despite us having missing no. Yeah, so I popped on drowsy. We also had the blanket, apparently. And yeah, you see the shots kind of pausing there. Modem lag is one of those items that's it's kind of like, who thought that we needed an item like this? I mean, I understand that every item can't just be a straight up banger, but like, come on. Like, who was like, yeah, you know, hey Tyrone, what's a good idea for an item?
We know how everyone loves lag, right? Well, how about we make an item that makes everything lag? Not just projectiles, but enemies too. That'd be so cool. Not as cool as Ragman, though.
That sounds like a great idea, Tyrone. Print it. Like, who thought like that was something that this game needed? Not me. Not my Isaac. And if you've ever wanted to see what 4.18 base damage looks like against Isaac, here you go. Shout out to Spider Mod Guy for us having Spider Mod. Yep. So, yeah, this is why Sinvicta does not like missing no. Because you get rolled into something that's awful, and then you're just stuck with it. Luckily, you're only stuck with it for a floor, but concurrently, if you get something that's super fun and awesome and overpowered, you also only get that for a floor. So it's catch 22, and let's hope that we don't get some kind of unlosable combo here for Boo Baby. I'm going to go back and get the stars card so we hopefully get teleported directly to him. We also have the school bag, which gives us an extra spacebar item. So it's possible we may roll into an extra one there. We did take a little bit of damage from that. Again, modem lag makes this almost impossible not to get hit by one, especially when they're all coming out like sort of stammered like that. And, yeah. We've been in this fight for about 10 minutes now. Probably not that far off an exaggeration. Even the bombs didn't do that much damage. We gotta try to fight Isaac in the middle of the room here. Because we cannot take... On this roll, we absolutely cannot go lose this HP. Because of our damage being so abysmal. I'm hoping that the game has saved the best for last, but... If I can show why missing no is bad, then it's all worth it. Unless you truly have nothing to lose, missing no is awful. And you can't get rid of it. That's another great idea. Can't get rid of it. He's done it. Okay. I forgot the stars card. I was so thrilled to be done with the Isaac fight, I forgot the stars card. And what did we roll into here? Tech 1. Well, we got better stats. Black Candida. The Ankh. Less than 3. Big Chub. Emperor card? Okay, so we're going to leave the... I'm going to leave the heart there. Wow, we've got so far to go. Range down. No, thanks. good. Do we have Godhead? We must have Godhead. We also have Curse of the Tower. But because we smelted the Safety Sisters, Curse of the Tower doesn't do anything. Yeah, we have to have Godhead because we have homing shots right now. Our attack one. And Fate's Reward is shooting Godhead Tears. We really need to stop taking damage here. Like, really bad. I also have glitter bombs and a whole lot of other bombs here. So we could theoretically, I wish that we had Dark Bomb, but we could theoretically make some items appear. Oh, never mind. Who needs items when you got the item? All right, that makes me feel a lot better about this reroll, because now I don't have to worry about using our shots as our primary damage source. And you're seeing here that Safety Scissors make an absolute joke out of Wrath. I can win on Sack Dagger. Wow. I don't know what slowed that shot down. Do we still have modem lag? We may still have the modem lag. That was weird how that one particular tier just slowed down. Sack Dagger nuking one of the Mega Maws there. Book of Revelations almost has a full charge on it. Very happy that we ended up taking that over Crooked Penny. Yeah, we still have modem lag. So that's fun. Okay, we got that. I also think that did we hold on to the Polaroid here? I don't think we did. No reason for us to go into that room to the left here, because we're going to have to go into this room anyway. Good damage on the Gurglings. Yeah, Dark Bomb would be nice right about now. You got something for me, Keybagger? Oh, you betcha. You bet your bottom dollar you do. Oh, we have Fate's Reward, though. Forgot about Fate's Reward. Godhead Ipecac. It's going to do a lot of damage. There we go. I think we just go in for the Sack Dagger play here. that makes that a little bit more difficult. But hey, we got there. We got there. It was a little bit tricky at the end, thanks to Missing No. But hey, at least you guys and gals get to see why Missing No is blacklisted. So thank you for watching, everyone. I really appreciate it. I hope you had a great start to your midweek. Again, thank you all very much for the support and the kind words. I promise you they are making a difference, and I cannot thank you enough. So until next time, so long, everybody. Thanks for watching this video. I'd like to thank some patrons like Gordon, Wiley, McAvoy, Zoe Reynolds, Grumpy Gargoyle, and Rory Smith. If you'd like to have your name butchered at the end of an Isaac episode, then please go over to my Patreon. It can be found at patreon.com/Sinvicta. Thank you all the September members out there in the mosh pit.